and we're looking at the empty spreadsheet like it will be on day one. The headings include column A, the works package ID from the WBS dictionary, column B, the total budgeted cost of each work package from the baseline budget, column C, the plan percent complete by this reporting period from the baseline schedule, column E, is the actual percent complete by the end of this reporting period, and you get this from the site inspections by the production teams actually doing the work, and column F is the actual cost from the project cost management system. And then there are columns with formulas. Column D, the plan cost at this reporting period, calculated from the works package total plan cost and the plan percentage complete. Column G is the difference between the plan percentage complete and the actual percentage complete, not used in the earned value management calculations, but for sure an early warning sign of things going off track. Column H is the earned value calculated from the percent actually complete and the budget at completion. Column I, the cost variation, the difference between the earned value and the actual cost. Column J, the cost performance index, a ratio of the earned value and the actual cost. Column K, the schedule variance, the difference between the earned value and the planned cost. Column L, the schedule performance index, a ratio of the earned value and the planned cost. And finally, column M, the estimate at completion. This is the total budgeted cost divided by the cost performance index. And the data we can fill in on day one is the works package ID, the budgeted cost for each work package, the planned percentage complete at day one will be zero, the planned cost at day one will be zero, and the actual cost on day one will be zero. And the total planned cost, cell B6, will be the sum of the individual work package budgets, and this is the budget at completion, the BAC. Now look at columns J, L and M. There are formulas in these cells that are divided by zero if the work package has no progress or hasn't started. And good old Excel tells us we have errors if we try to divide by zero. It's a pain in the butt, but let's delete all the formulas in these cells except for the first work package in row 7. And now let's time travel to the end of the first reporting period. And when we look at the progress of work package 111, the planned percent complete is 75%, and it just so happens that the production team reported at 75% complete. And would you believe the actual cost is reported at 7,500? So for this work package, we are dead on track, with a CPI of 1 and an SPI of 1. And the estimate completion, column M, is the same as the budget, column B. Well done. Work package 112 should be 50% complete, and it is. The actual percent complete is 50%. But it looks like we've spent more than budget up to date. We've spent 6,000, but the budget is only 5,000. And the CPI is at 0.83, and the budget at completion is 12,000, 2,000 above the baseline budget. So we had better keep an eye on that one. Let's look at work package 113. Here, the planned completion is 25%, but we've actually completed 50%. Ahead of schedule. Well done. And even better, the actual costs are not much more than the earned value. The actual cost at 5,500 and the earned value at 5,000, giving a cost variation of 500. The CPI is less than 1 at 0.91, but within our tolerance level. And the SPI is above 1, so we are ahead of schedule. Work package 121 is a different story. The planned completion is 75%, but the actual completion is only 25%, with a planned cost of 11,250 and an actual cost of 5,000. We are in deep red on this one, for both CPI and SPI, with an estimate at completion 33% over budget. Drastic action is necessary to correct this one. Now let's consider the estimate at completion for the whole project. Currently shows in cell M6 at 53,000, well below the budget at completion of 250,000 in cell B6. Something definitely wrong here. And it's because we have added up the budgeted cost for all the works packages in column B, but we have only added up the work packages in progress in column M. For the works packages not yet scheduled to start, we can assume that the estimate at completion will be the same as the budget at completion. So, we can copy-paste the budget in column B to the estimate at completion in column M, for all the works packages not yet started. Now, that is a little bit controversial, because we're assuming that the future work will go as planned. We're not taking into account the past performance of the project, which is what earned value analysis is all about, right? We should be multiplying each work package budget by the average CPI to date to get a more accurate estimate at completion. It's another level of sophistication that we can talk about later. And we can see that we are slightly over budget at the end of reporting period 1. Nothing too serious at the moment, but let's keep our eyes and ears open, right? Now let's add the traffic lights with a little conditional formatting. Our tolerance levels for both CPI and SPI are above 0.9, all okay. Between 0.8 and 0.9, okay, but let's try to improve. And below 0.8, drastic action necessary to correct the situation. Format the one cell and paint that format down the columns. So there you have it, basic earned value management. For sure, we can add some Excel magic to make the job of completing the workshop easier and automatic, and for improving the accuracy of the metrics by including the past performance of the production teams. And I'll leave that to you, and maybe you can share the results in the course discussion area. And I'll see you in the next lecture.